That's what Battle Royale games are all about. It's outlasting, out-tacticking, getting every single thing you can, out-looting, and putting your resources to the test, whether it's the light ammunition in the prevalently run minigun, how well you shockwave retake, how well are you utilizing your mats and maintaining your position, and when you do go, how well are you going?
One HP, Wavy Jacob pick it up a knock. Rich Homie Quinn goes down as well in the feed. Meanwhile, not Mongrel, not Tfue, and not Booga, that's for sure. Setting up shop at the edge for a little bit of a storm hold. We will see. By the way, one of the Pelicans did just get knocked in the feed as well.
Okay, right now, though, for where we are, the Pelicans do have a long way to go. I think these guys might be making a mistake on what they're doing once again. We saw, we talked about it, the cost of doing these early game storm holds never actually come with good benefits.
True. That being said, they didn't necessarily know how much HP was left, unless they had engaged them previously. But pushing on the storm, not Mongrel picks up some loot there. Quick eliminations. Both players were already very, very weak. So I would agree, in a majority of situations, making this kind of play call to sit and wait. It's happened literally multiple times today where players give up their positioning to fight right at the edge, and they end up, it ends up costing them because they have to move so far. But right here, it works out just simply because the players were already so low.
Yeah, it's a personal mistake that I usually make when I see a rainbow loadout with me and my team. You have shocks, you have a heavy sniper and an RPG. That's not really stuff you utilize to get these early game elims or have such a priority on, right? But this is why these guys are the pros. They know exactly how to divvy out the pressure and exactly what to use. Not that much HP damage taken either. It's very easily taken back from Siphon. One very interesting biome we're at now, though, is the big skull in the middle of the map from that Doggus versus Caddis fight we saw earlier on last season. Over here, that high ground, just like Gotham City, there might not be redeploy for Pizus, there's no chance to survive, but when you're in this actual zone or this portion of the map, you can build all the way up. As long as you're connected to the sword that's in the monster's skull, you will actually not drop and have chances to catch yourself on the way down.
Not a wild chance to get very, very high elevation up above as players are making this rotation. Booga, Tfue, Mongrel going to make their way over to a launch pad that was placed not long ago. Lozman down there in Blix as well on your screen. Player's going to rotate in from behind. They might actually end up using the same launch pad, which means there you go, landing on the side of the hill, looking back, trying to take shots. These players that are still on the move, one flying all the way past. Looks like fake Booga trying to find a landing zone down there so that these guys can keep on moving forward. You don't want to wait too long against the edge of the storm. You're going to pay the price in HP, which means if you make a mistake, and here we go, challenging up top. Take a look at this. Tfue looking back up from underneath, opts for the launch, and Blix does go down, which means Loadsman still out there somewhere in the storm. This is an aggressive push to get back up, to get these materials, the siphon off of it, but Blix does go down. There's a little bit of a pickup, actually very smart, because there are more rockets in there, more RPG shots, going to prove important late game if they can make it all the way to the end. Ton of builds left. See Loadsman on your minimap for just a second, flying in there. Looks like he's going to make his way into Gotham City. Right there, bobbing his way in down that little valley. Meanwhile, not Tfue, still stuck out in the river. Going to tick quite a bit, and there, hear that audio cue? That's the reboot van going down, and I guarantee you, you're about to see these guys are going to swan dive on it. Reason not to.
They hear exactly what's going on. It is shield bubble, though, which is very good. You brought up two very good points, smart decisions, as well as timing and playing the amount of time you are in the game, right? It's game six. You want to make sure you're making all the right calls, all the efficient calls as well. Mongrel with a big shot does miss, unfortunately. I want to give a quick shout out to Blix, actually, who did go down in that fight. These guys were landing block the whole time for the first five games. From where they are based, kind of context to their position, they kind of switched off where their landing spot was to get a better chance for the actual fight of the later in portion of the game. The big thing noted, though, once you're dropping at a spot you're not used to, that's where mid-game fights don't actually come into fruition. Right now, though, Major Mongrel looking in at Beam's white tags as well with stakes. This is huge for them.
This is a dirty third party, to be honest. They're sitting at the edge of the storm looking back through the blue, and there's two squads fighting it out in the storm. Even if they just get one tag, and then these guys end up not pressuring each other, that means these three sitting up on the hill do get those eliminations. See, still a little bit of a fight. There we go. The knock, literally, as I said, not Mongrel picks up the knock on chicken. You see in the feed, Loadsman actually does finish that one off, which ends up being a siphon for the team on the outside. Player flying in. And there it is. And there it is. Loadsman goes down. These guys played that perfectly, waiting, just forcing the fight. Whether they are or not, they know that that last player is still inside Gotham remains to be seen, and we will find out here in a second. There it is, the shots from underneath. You're going to have those players up top try and coordinate as well. This is honestly one of the best plays they could have made. even with Nabuga pushing out into the storm, take a little bit of damage there. They still picked up multiple elims off of this, and I mean, they're still in a decent spot.
Yep, the big thing to actually note here is that you said it yourself, smart decisions. Usually you can only see this when the zone is so much smaller in the end game, you know, looking back at blue, holding people in the storm. But doing it mid game, first of all, takes a big risk because you spend so much time in that investment. You spend so many resources not actually getting into the zone. It's huge for them to get those points because right now,
oh,
this is the last
on.
Game, no way.
Yo. I can't even deal with this right now. By the way, Hellback Dog, Bubby, and Jay Roses are the first place team for NA West right now. They are an 18-point lead over third, which is the next closest team that is still in here. Remember, second place got eliminated earlier. A little bit of a take the L right there, and honestly, I don't blame you. What a shot. Clyphon goes down so far away.
Imagine the confidence boost you have from that, the amount of room you kind of push yourself with.
Yo, they hit those.
Yeah, they do hit those.
They hit those.
They've hit a really good spot in the server as well. There, I believe 55 other players have been knocked out. There's 45 left. That's 100% a possibility of some of those top 10 trios not being in contention. Less threat for them as well. They're sitting so high on the server, but even in their minds, they're probably just relaxing, feet kicked up, waiting for the game to play for them.
You, at this point, like you said, wait for the game to play for them. They have to just sit and buy their time. The opportunities will present themselves. I think one of the things about a competitive player in Fortnite that is very important is patience. You don't have to be the person that's pushing the storm and going after every single fight. If you know where you are on the board, you know where you are, you know, point-wise, you know when to make those kind of plays, when they'll present themselves right here. Jay Roses, he's not stepping out too far. I think right here, biding his time, waiting for this shot. A little bit of a team fire there. The heavy snipe to break the wall and gets two tags, including a headshot on the player, literally flying through the air. Well done from Jay Roses and squad. They're not the only ones up here, though. You see on the minimap, a few teams, looks like three trios, one only a duo, to the south, plus that team to the north still in it.
And they think that Bubby, Hellback Dog, and Jay Roses are going to have the toughest time actually getting into the circle from their position. At the same time, though, they can use a launch pad themselves. They can wait for a recycled launch pad, too. They're going to be moving in using their own utility to make sure they're on their own page, go somewhere they want to base up, and then play their own game, waiting for the server to respond to them.
It's like a tough little build up there for just a second. It's blocked out by a teammate, but able to match height. Shield bubble goes down, an opportunity to kind of descend without getting challenged on the way in. Jay Rose is here sitting at 190. That being said, Hellback Dog on maybe 40 HP. Meanwhile, on your screen, Psalm, Aiden, Sean all stacked up also in that same shield bubble. Looks like they were the ones that almost challenged. They pushed for that. And then down at the bottom, your trio of birds, the Pelicans down there. 16 trios, by the way, remaining in the final match of NA West. This is the last game of the Fortnite Champions Series. If you have tuned in, please make sure you've grabbed any clips, anything crazy that's happened. Make sure you hit us up on Twitter with this, including that shot on Sean as Jay Roses. They were just challenged moments ago. Jay finds a bead there. Shots from underneath as Bubby's trying to find, match those hits. Can't quite do it. A 114 is great, but does go down. Trade that may not be worth it in the grand scheme of things. They are, in fact, by the way, fighting. This is a first place versus third place battle of the leaderboard in these boxes. Hellback Dog going to have to drop down. This is literally going to make the difference potentially between a first and second. The team in third, we will see Sean, Aiden, and Psalm there. Hellback Dog gets dropped. Symmetrical pushes in. We have another team rolling in as Jay Roses is left out by himself.
It seems that when Hellback Dog goes down, the top dogs of the server come rolling in, hungry to see what they can eat and gain off from points for the rest of this game. Once again, the ripple effect, I will mention it every game. This is the last time, though, since it is the last game. Eliminating someone in first place makes it so that it's so much easier for you to catch up. It lessens the chance for them to get points. Right now as well, this zone, some of the most interesting gameplay you can see based on who has an advantage. It's a big mountain with low ground. The possibility of a bounce back either way could prove monumental for anyone up top on the mountain or anyone on the other side of the zone. It's a very big 50-50 risk.
I want you to know that quote is going to get memed on Reddit. You said the most interesting gameplay, and we're watching Jay Roses basically bide his time. That being said, I do not fault him for waiting in there. At that point, there's no reason to step out. You have multiple fights going down, and since he is a solo, unless you have a guarantee or a window peek, maybe a floor edit that you can peek through, take some shots at people undetected, there's no reason to move, and that's exactly what he ended up doing right there. You have J-Truth, Scruples down there on the bottom. Not Mongrel, Tfue, and Booga. Gonna hold this edit. Watch this combo right there. Big hit inside through the wall. Looks like some 116s from the Rocket. They're gonna decide to apply pressure at this point. The heavy snipe still in. Not Mongrel's inventory, I believe, is loaded, but behind. Now Buga does get knocked. Gonna push back in. Quick reset on some of the surfaces. I don't think he got both the pyramid and the floor as he moved through there. So there's only half of what could be blocking out there, but it is metal, shouldn't be a big deal. The pickup right here, maybe a little mini and HP share. We'll see 53 points, a total of 8 eliminations thus far, and 4 more trios need to go down before we get into placement. We're at the 50-50 zone and shots beaming players on the move. At this point, they may have to themselves worry about this surface that they're on because there are still players above. See here, here's the shot. Here's the shot. You have to not, you can't tunnel vision for too long. Yeah, you got the knock on Nibs. Fantastic. Now make sure you divert your attention to those that are immediately around you. So I guarantee you, this edit that they're sitting on right now, it is being watched from at least one person above. It would be ridiculous to assume otherwise. You cannot get too confident here. Nibs, the position he was just in moments ago before he got eliminated, now taken over by other players. Wallaker in the feed, picking up an Elim, and here we go, the pressure, the minigun combo, the shockwave to get back into the safe zone, but that does not mean they're going to stop firing. Not Mongrel, not Tifu, not Buga, continuing this aggressive behavior. 9 eliminations, they do still have a launch pad, and here we go, you see the edits just up above. It blows my mind that no one is taking a peek from the top to see if they can get a hit on somebody. Fratby and Squad are just above them. Mongrel, the team sitting at 55 points. Here we go, a little bit of an edit. It'll look up above. They do that edit and then immediately break to get through as fast as they can. We'll see if they can find a beat on somebody else here.
Yep, half pad comes through. You talk about all eyes on you, Lupo, with that edit. With 30 people just left alive, 14 trios were almost at placement. I think the server knows that now as well. The big thing being, every movement you make on the bottom side of this map, anyone trying to get ahead of zone is seen. Not Tfue gets seen first out of everyone on the server by Ghost Aiden, who's also in contention for being a big boy on the leaderboards later after we see the standings on the final game of NA West Game 6. Now the rotations come in on the moving zone. Thankfully, everything's away from the mountain. It's going to be pure skill going forward on natural low ground that doesn't change too much. The health bar of Mesa Bruga is going to change big time. They have to leave their teammate behind. No chance of a res, no chance to get shields down. A risky launch pad, 16 HP, using the cover of trees to move around. He only has 1 mini to base up with unless he sticks with his teammate. All the hard mats being used, only 200 left. They need to make a split. The minigun is in use in their inventory, but they won't have the room to use it if they don't have the HP.
A sacrificial play there to get out. Down to 2 players left. Not Mongrel sitting at 6 eliminations and still about 140 HP. Meanwhile, Liquid River Sun cease and elevate from 100 Thieves. Get the knock. Machin goes down. The elimination. Siphon comes through, pushing out and making this tunnel happen as they try to track down as many players as they can on the move. Everybody's got to go north. Cease down to only 82 HP. That one shield right there as well. Going to move through, follow, elevate. You want basically elevate to be the front of this steam engine pushing through to the next section of builds, and Cease 113 now. Get a look back, make sure nobody's following a very intelligent play. And this is, that right there is huge for trios. He doesn't have to worry about what's in front. His job is to watch behind, and he does an excellent job. Nobody's back there, but he does have a chance right there for just a second, maybe a little bit of a pre-fire on the shoddy. Finds a teammate knocked, but the shotgun comes through and Aiden goes down. The remainder of that trio is eliminated. River Sun does have to be sacrificed to the storm.
Yep, right now, Cease is going to be the front man of this trio. He's going to be looking everything at the back, all the points available from the storm. Although Elevate might be the one pathing and making the plays in front of him, Cease has to confirm. As I just said, Elevate goes down. He's the last one left, has the shields, the bigs, might not be used. Elevate on the bottom. He's going to try to stay protected. He finally goes down. Cease takes an RPG to the face. 3 trios left, 4 people alive in the last game, 29 HP. The numbers getting lower, lower, and lower in placement and health resources. Cease built fighting in zone for height, doesn't actually get it, almost does actually. I'm not sure who's on height. It might be him. He checks, he gets up, his entire playground, but he doesn't have the tools or the building blocks to play with.
It's a 1v1 situation. Cease and 100 Thieves on his back right now, looking down from above. 5 eliminations, an opportunity, a crazy opportunity to top shield off. You do not see that very often. Lalaker sitting at almost the same HP, although it's totally shifted to the green bar. Cease, the ultimate high ground,
A little bit of a beam from above. There's just a little bit of pressure. Lalakirp, you see him popping the full shield. Cease might hear the audio cue and know that this is going to be a 100-100 player in just a minute. We will see. He's going to have to find a big pump shot. We've talked about it repeatedly. That's basically the theme right now. He doesn't have the inventory for a heal off. He's going to have to go for it. Only 10 builds, and this might be the shot right here. Maybe an SMG spray, a drop down with a pump, and a swap to the SMG is kind of the only opportunity. Lalakirp, this is a back and forth. The dance for the victory royale of game six for NA West. Cease, a little bit of pressure. The SMG shots from above. He's going to build those layers. The drop in forces a 95 shotgun shot. Still shield in there. Finds a little bit of damage, but cannot escape.
And that's it. That is the final game out of NA West. We'll see you guys on the Battle Bus. Ready, let go. Get aside if you ever.